Hey everybody, what's going on? This is Jesse Swift. I apologize if I come across a little tired this morning. First thing I did when I woke up is I looked over and I checked my phone and saw that there was a new X-Men Apocalypse trailer, so I wanted to give my official reaction, and I held off on watching it until right now. So it's going to be my first just kind of fresh and raw reaction to it. Going into it though, my expectations are not all that high. I think they made some exciting casting decisions. I think Bryan Singer is responsible for some of the better X-Men movies that we've had. I was extremely underwhelmed by the previous entry, which was X-Men Days of Future Past. It didn't do anything for me. By the time the credits rolled in the theater, I was very bored. I did not go and see it again. I don't really care if I see it again. And it's a really bittersweet relationship because I am very indifferent when it comes to the movies. However, the 90s X-Men cartoon is what got me into being a comic book and superhero lover. And then the X-Men comics were some of the richest, most fulfilling stories about being an outcast and finding your ground and being happy and proud of who you are. And I think they just had some of the greatest message. Plus, there was the symmetry between X-Men and then the civil rights movement. You had Professor Xavier that was similar to Martin Luther King, and then Magneto that was similar to Malcolm X in the movement. And I just found that to be absolutely fascinating. It wasn't until I got older that I made that connection, but I think that the X-Men stories still hold up and are really fantastic, and I wish that the movies would start catching up with the source material. So, without further ado, let's look up the trailer for X-Men Apocalypse. Here it is.
I saw the end of the world. I could feel all this death.
Jean. Sansa as Jean. She's not hiding her accent very well. Song.
Many things over many lifetimes. Ra, Krishna, Yahweh.
Ever since the world found out about mutants, there have been secret societies who see them as some kind of second coming or sign of God. They believe that tens of thousands of years ago, ancient beings.
This is similar to the leaked trailer from Comic-Con. I saw a little bit of that. Everybody hates the look of Apocalypse. I think it's one of the best looking things to the trailer.
He always had four followers he would imbue with power.
Like the four horsemen of the Apocalypse. He got that one from the Bible.
Where the Bible got it from him.
What is it?
Oh God. He can control all of us.
The world needs the X-Men.
That's why I'm here. To fight.
All of us can control our powers.
Then don't. This is war.
Everything they built.
Oh, cool. They're going when Apocalypse came bigger. Archangel looks awesome. Okay, so this last bit is looking cooler. Well, if anybody watching knows me well, you know that I have ranked my anticipation for 2016 in the movies that I'm looking forward to, and X-Men Apocalypse has been at the bottom of that list. It's been,
Hey guys, Group Longwave, I'm Eric.
I'm Eric.
My number one most anticipated movie for 2016, of course, we're not counting Star Wars, because that's coming out in just a few days here. But number one would be Batman vs. Superman, Dawn of Justice. And then after that, probably Suicide Squad. And then Civil War, or no, sorry, Doctor Strange, and then Civil War, and then lastly, I guess, would be X-Men Apocalypse, but it's just really on the bottom of the list. This trailer has not changed my judgment whatsoever. If I had not seen this trailer today, it wouldn't have made a difference. It really didn't reveal anything to me. I already knew who the actors were. I knew what the plot was. I am no more excited now than I was. I will see this probably opening day when it comes out, just because of curiosity and being an X-Men fan. This movie looks like a higher budget than most X-Men movies. Like, there's more at stake. Casting Oscar Isaac, Isaacs as Apocalypse, I think, was a really great idea. And I'm looking forward to seeing a younger generation of X-Men. I think the younger Storm is probably a better fit than Halle Berry, who I thought was very poor casting. I like the young Cyclops. We get Nightcrawler again, which is very cool. I am really, really tired of Jennifer Lawrence in this franchise. I don't think she's a fit. I don't like how much they focus on her character. Mystique has never really been a focus of the overarching comics for X-Men. She's just getting this much of a role because of her star power. So there's a lot of things I'm not excited for, that I'm irritated about. Not to be just one of the typical fanboys, but I wish that Marvel would get X-Men back, because I'm not really looking forward to it. Interesting things is there's been suspicions that Wolverine will show up in this movie and Gambit might show up in this movie before his spinoff, but we didn't see either of them in the trailer, so we'll see when the movie comes out on Memorial Day. So until then, I'll see you guys later. Leave your comments and thoughts down below, and may the film be with you. Always.